On average, a hemodialysis patient can be exposed to 300 to 600 liters of water per week. This puts them at a high risk for exposure to waterborne pathogens. Repetitive exposure to chemicals or microbiological agents that are present in hemodialysis fluids can cause serious harm to patients like bacterial or fungal infections, chemical intoxication, hepatitis, and gram-negative bloodstream infections. To keep patients free from waterborne illnesses, frequent and proper testing and disinfection of the dialysis machines must be performed. In this video, we'll demonstrate how to properly collect samples for testing the portable reverse osmosis machines. The tests we'll be demonstrating are bacteria, microbiological and endotoxin test, and an AMI chemical contaminants test. Before conducting the test, the technician, along with relevant leadership and departments, should come up with a proactive plan in case any of the product water or portable RO machine results fall outside the acceptable levels for any of the tests. It's a good idea to reference this table from the CDC and the Association for the Advancement of Medical Instrumentation, AMI, that lists the established chemical and microbiological standards that must be adhered to for the water used to prepare dialysate, substitution fluid, or to reprocess hemodialyzers for renal replacement therapy. More information about this table can be found on the CDC's website. In addition, always familiarize yourself with the RO machine's manufacturer's instructions for use and testing. Now we'll be performing these tests simultaneously. At least 15 minutes prior to any testing, turn on the machine if it's not running already to prevent the collection of stagnant water that could lead to inaccurate readings. Take a moment to gather all the supplies you'll need, as the requirements may vary for each test. For these tests, you'll need gloves, goggles, sterile test tube, sterile sample cup, alcohol wipes, permanent marker for labeling samples, bucket, biohazard bag, small bag of ice, forms to record testing. First, begin with hand hygiene. Then, don goggles and gloves. Place a bucket under the product water sample port. Using an alcohol wipe, wipe the tip of the product water sample port for 5 seconds. Let it air dry, then turn on the port, letting the water flow into the bucket. Always follow the manufacturer's instructions for disinfecting the sample port. Before collecting the sample for bacteria and microbiological and endotoxin tests, you must let the water flow for at least 1 minute. During this time, doff your gloves, perform hand hygiene, and don a new pair of gloves. The bacterial test measures the TVC, total viable microbial count. This test is also sometimes referred to as HPC, heterotrophic plate counts. The microbiological and endotoxin test measures EU, or allowable level water endotoxin unit. This test is also known as LAL, limulus amebocyte lysate. Both of these tests can come from one sample. These tests must be performed weekly on all new systems prior to the first use until 4 results are obtained within the maximum allowable levels. They are collected from all portable ROs on a monthly basis and for bacterial tests more often during outbreaks. Additionally, collect HPC and LAL tests right before regular disinfection of portable ROs. The samples should be drawn from the port, labeled Product Water Sample Port. AMI chemical contaminant testing is done when the reverse osmosis machine is installed, when membranes are replaced, and annually. The sample should also be collected from the same product water sample port. Grab the sterile tube that will be used for this test and label it with the name of the RO machine you're testing. This tube will be used for bacteria and microbiological and endotoxin testing. Uncap the test tube and take your sample using the clean catch method. Once the test tube is filled, replace the cap and turn the tube upside down once to ensure there is no leakage. Next, we'll collect the sample for the AMI chemical analysis. Before collecting this sample, the water must have run for at least 2 minutes. Take your sterile sample cup and label it with the name of the RO machine. Additionally, write AMI chemical analysis to signify what test the sample will be used for. Remove the cap and again, using the clean catch method, retrieve your sample, filling the cup entirely. Replace the cap, turning it upside down once to ensure it's not leaking. Turn off the nozzle. Place both samples into a biohazard bag and place them on a small bag of ice. Follow your institution's and laboratory's protocols for completing forms and sending specimens for testing. Place your completed forms, test samples in the biohazard bag, and the bag of ice in the fridge. These samples should be assayed within 1 to 2 hours of collection or refrigerated immediately in a temperature-controlled and monitored refrigerator and assayed within 24 hours. Portable ROs should also be tested for chlorine and chloramine levels when in use. This test should be performed every 4 hours or before each treatment using a dip and read test kit. Follow the label and manufacturer's instructions for chlorine and chloramine testing. Notify appropriate personnel if results exceed 0.1 parts per million. In addition to proper testing, it's also important to regularly disinfect the portable RO machines. The water distribution loops, main RO, and portable ROs should be disinfected on a monthly basis. Additionally, the inlet line on dialysis machines and portable ROs should also be disinfected on a monthly basis. Carbon filters must be maintained and changed per manufacturer's recommendation. For the safety of your hemodialysis patients, it's imperative that water samples are collected in both a proper and timely fashion to ensure that the treatment water maintains safe and healthy levels.